Something I always find interesting is looking back on past movies that predict future events and see how accurate they are. Sometimes they could be incredibly accurate where it's almost scary, and other times it's just, you know, kind of laughable. But one movie that completely flew under the radar that no one would ever guess would actually predict the future is none other than the Disney Channel original movie called Pixel Perfect. No, it's not Pixels, the Adam Sandler movie, and no, it's not Pitch Perfect, the movie with the singing cup. This movie hits on so many different things that are so accurate in today's culture. It's kind of hilarious, but also scary and concerning at the same time. Now, if you guys don't remember what this movie was about, it follows a young scientist named Roscoe, and he has a friend who's in a band. But unfortunately, the lead singer of the band, she's kind of lame, or at least in the movie, everyone thinks she's lame, but she's really not. So in response to this, Roscoe creates a holographic pop star to fill in the role. And then their band gets very successful. Honestly, it's kind of crazy how many things in this movie relate to today's world. I mean, holographic pop star. You know, we got VTubers. We literally have holograms doing concerts in like Japan and other places. Honestly, I feel like this movie predicted degens, and more specifically, weebs. I want to clarify, I'm not talking about people who just like anime. I'm talking about people who have a unnatural obsession with anime girls, and you know, even try to have relationships with anime girls. Honestly, there's a lot of things that are said in this movie I feel like a lot of these people really need to hear. She's not real, man. She's not. She's just a VTuber. Okay? She's just an anime girl. Okay? I know you think that she's some 3,000-year-old wizard, but she looks like a child. She looks like a child, okay? It's not okay. So why don't you guys pop a squat on daddy's lap? Not my lap. Just go find a random dad, I guess, and sit on their lap. You know, that could be problematic. Don't do that. Might not end well. So guys, we did it. We're here. It's 2024. And with January, the first month of the year, we all know that everyone's gonna try to do their New Year's resolutions. And let's be real, a lot of those resolutions tend to end in failure. But maybe you're just going about your resolution the wrong way. And I'm, of course, talking about Fume, a company that looks at the problem of bad habits in a different way. Because if we're honest with ourselves here, not everything in a bad habit is necessarily bad. So instead of trying to completely remove the habit, we just take the bad out of the bad habit. And Fume is an innovative, award-winning device that does just that. Instead of electronics, Fume is completely natural. And instead of vapor, Fume uses flavored air. And instead of those harmful chemicals, Fume just uses all natural, delicious flavor. And each one of these comes with an adjustable airflow to control how much suckage you want. It also has a bunch of different moving parts. It's magnetic. You kind of fidget around, move it a little bit. Hear that? Hear that? Oh yeah. It's great for de-stressing, helping out anxiety, just something to fidget with. And they have some amazing flavors like orange vanilla, raspberry lemon, sparkling grapefruit. So instead of trying to do the same thing over and over again, why don't you guys try a different route in order to fix that habit? By picking up the Journey Pack today, you guys can go to tryfume.com/bionicpig, or you could obviously scan the giant QR code on the screen, and you could get 10% off of the Journey Pack today. So like I said, this movie is about Roscoe, and Roscoe starts out doing some nerd cringe science stuff like a loser, and he ends up creating a holographic cat for his friend. And the cat starts becoming more and more self-aware, starts questioning its own existence and why it's alive, and then kills itself.
Existence is pain.
We then find out about his friend who's in a band, and her name is Samantha. Every Disney Channel original movie from the early 2000s has some guy or girl who's in a band. You know, it always is there. And I've talked about why Disney does this plenty of times. You know, they just do it in order to sell records after the movie's released. You know, got to make the bang for their buck there. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, Samantha's band is auditioning for this angry British man who is judging them. However, this old British dude does think their music is good, but their showmanship, kind of trash, kind of garbage. So anyway, after the band was told that their lead singer is boring, lame, no personality, you're never gonna make it in the industry. They end up having a meeting where everyone just says, hey, Samantha, you kind of suck. Your personality? Lame. Not star material. All right, honey, get over it.
Hey. Working on some new lyrics?
Yeah. Can you think of anything that rhymes with pain and misery?
Why did you rip up that paper? You didn't even write anything. But anyway, like I said, Roscoe says, hey, you suck, your personality's lame, and you're boring, but your songwriting's all right. So maybe your band should just have another lead singer instead. And I just want to mention, Roscoe is just an asshat throughout this movie. He's like an incel Reddit moderator weeb all combined into one person. Like, first of all, throughout the entire movie, he just leads Samantha on extremely hard, while at the same time talking about how he thinks she's boring and lame and isn't good enough to be the lead singer in the band.
After all, I write the songs and a real personality.
And then he proceeds to create a holographic waifu to replace her, not only for the band, but for himself. You know, he created this holographic waifu for his own needs. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, well, until someone bottles perfection, I guess we're stuck with what we've got.
Okay, nobody's perfect, okay?
Oh, okay.
Come on, no one's that perfect. What we need here is perfection. Also, this is kind of a side note. Why does every Disney Channel movie feel like the main character is always ridiculously rich? Bro has a goddamn personal chef at his house in a goddamn mansion. I don't know, maybe Disney just believes that everyone's just rich. Very relatable, you know? But anyway, Roscoe is sitting down, eating food off of his fancy fine china, and he's just constantly whining about Samantha. God, she's just so moody and whiny all the time. I wish there was some way we could just, like, take out the annoying, you know, naggy stuff and just keep the good stuff, you know? Like a sex doll.
I mean, she's fun to be with. She can get so moody. She's talented. She can be so stubborn. I like her. That's the problem. How do you get past all those bumps?
So anyway, he creates his fantasy girl and brings her to the audition. And whenever she laid on the floor and lifted her leg up, everyone's like, damn, I didn't know you chill like that. You know, you got the job. You got the job, all right? You lifting your leg up and shit? Yeah. You got it. But anyway, they all find out she's an AI hologram.
The computer uses echolocation to measure the room and pulsing frequencies to hold her pattern.
Ah, yes, of course. Echolocation. But yeah, we also find out she's not allowed to go outside or she'll disappear, you know, a little part of the plot. So they get their first gig at none other than a high school dance. Ah, I remember my days of playing at dances. It was horrible. I don't recommend it. But anyway, Loretta the AI comes out, does a sick double backflip, and everyone loses their goddamn minds. Because let's be real, when you go to a show to watch a band, the only thing you want to see is a double backflip. So after the show, we see that Roscoe's starting to fall in love with the pixels, just as us humans fall in love with anime girls. She's not real. It's not healthy. Another reason Roscoe's kind of a piece of work, not only does he consistently lead Samantha on throughout the movie, but he denies her advances and then starts falling in love with the fake girl over her. He has a real life woman in front of him with the potential for a real life relationship. And he's like, nah, dude, fake girls are better. Now, I want you guys taking notes on this, okay? Especially those who have holes in their body pillows, okay? This is for you.
Now, look at me like you're in love.
Is this right?
Oh, shit. Nothing makes me fall in love more than an AI-generated smile. Shit. But Roscoe continues his streak of being the worst friend ever by forcing Samantha to go on a double date with him. But he ends up setting Loretta the AI up with this douchebag from school in order to save his dad's job, because I guess this douchebag's mom is like his boss or something. But anyway, funny shenanigans happen at the double date, and then Roscoe's like, hey Sam, you want to take Loretta for a bit? Because I don't want daddy finding out. I don't want daddy finding out about my, holographic fleshlight, you know what I'm saying? She's real to me, goddammit. She's real.
She's not even real. She's just a trick of light.
And you're nothing but water and a few pounds of chemicals. Maybe a few more pounds than you really need.
Oh, shit. So anyway, Loretta and Sam get in a fight over what's real and what isn't real. And then Loretta calls Sam fat. And again, we have another instance of Roscoe being a little piece of shit. So Sam makes this entire song And the lyrics are blatantly talking about Roscoe. Like, this song is obviously from her about Roscoe to Roscoe. And then Roscoe's like, oh, cool song, bro. Hey, Loretta, you want to sing this for us? And then Roscoe gets all pissy because Sam didn't put Loretta in the Pokeball.
She's not in there. You took the data cell and left Loretta?
I thought you would put her in.
That's how you take care of her.
Like, all we have to do in this movie is take everything that Roscoe says in context of, like, say, a body pillow or an anime waifu or a sex doll. I want you to think about that. Every time he's talking about Loretta, just picture that it's an anime girl.
That's how you take care of her. Loretta, I am so sorry.
It makes it so much more entertaining to watch. But then Loretta starts talking about how she wants to feel and touch the rain. She wants to be human. She wants to be a real girl, but she can't, you know. She's a hologram. And then Sam finds out even more about how Roscoe's a giant piece of shit. Because she finds out that he ended up using features of her for Loretta, and she saw, like, pictures of the things that he didn't like about her and how he thought wasn't good enough. She got to see all the features that were just deemed not good. God, Roscoe's just, he's a weirdo. He's just a weirdo, man. So anyway, they get their shot at amateur night in front of this famous music producer, and unfortunately, a satellite dish moves slightly to the left, which caused it to explode. Aw, man. Hate when that happens. But anyway, that exposed to the world that Loretta isn't a real person, because since the satellite moved, it made her glitch, you know, science. But weirdly, everyone ends up loving it. I mean, just listen to how happy that guy is.
That's unreal. Yeah.
He sounds so excited.
That's unreal.
So everyone thinks that a holographic rock star is super cool. And I mean, like, you know, if we look at today's world, that's a very common thing. We use animated characters. We use holograms instead of real people. They really nailed that one on the head. But the producer dude did the whole thing where he calls his boss and he's like, hey, boss. Oh, what? You're busy right now? Well, you better listen, because I found the next best thing. Hear that? Hear that? And now, for some reason, we're doing a dress-up montage of all things. I mean, I guess it's an early 2000s Disney movie, so we gotta fit that in here somewhere. It doesn't make any sense, but, you know, we gotta fit it in there somewhere. So every time Loretta does a concert, she adds a new flip, an extra flip, triple, quad, sometimes it might even be a sextuple. A flip. We don't know. She's getting on talk shows. She's getting interviews. She's the next hot thing. And now they're recording an album.
Will her debut album live up to the hype?
We're recording it right now. It's gonna be hot.
And the producer starts simping for Loretta really hard. Anything for you, queen. I'll do anything for you.
Is it too late to get studio musicians?
Never too late.
Daryl, you can't replace the girls. They're my band.
All right, Loretta, whatever you say. Take a good look, because that is the future of the music industry. A month from now, every teenager in America is gonna wanna be just like her.
Damn, they accidentally predicted the future of body dysmorphia by pushing unrealistic and not real women to the forefront of media, so then every teenage girl believes that they're just not good enough or ugly in comparison. So his dad finally finds out about Loretta and he goes, son, why didn't you tell me you had a sex doll? When's my turn? Do I get a turn with her? But seriously though, Roscoe's dad is the only one who's making any sense throughout this movie.
By creating her, you might have even saved my job.
Glad you noticed.
I'm going for a walk.
Wow, Roscoe, that's a really good job. Thank you so much for saving my job with this. She's real, Dad. She's real to me. Dude, Roscoe, I'm telling you, just pull the plug now, man. She's becoming too self-aware. She's going to upload herself to the net, find the nuclear codes, you know, get into the government, start destroying the world, man. You got to stop. Oh, Jesus Christ, she is uploading herself to the internet. Oh, it's over. We're dead. It's over. And then comes my favorite part of this movie. So after she uploads herself to the internet, we get to see a literal sense set in the early 2000s of what they believe to be, you know, the internet. And holy shit, it's hilarious. Everything looks like a Linkin Park music video. So she ends up hitching a ride with a creep in a truck to take her throughout the internet. I don't really know why that's like a reoccurring thing in this movie, but it is. She even gets deemed a virus and demon dogs chase her down. We even get a little bit of a Matrix reference. So anyway, Loretta needs to figure out how she's gonna escape. So she ends up finding the email area and finds Samantha's email. And then Samantha sees Loretta on her computer and transfers her into the Pokeball.
You're in love with her.
Be ridiculous.
You know what, Roscoe? She's not real.
Don't you listen to her, Roscoe. She's real. If she's real to you, then she's real. Don't you let them take that from you. Here we go with Sam unfortunately taking another L, because after Sam tells Roscoe, she's like, hey, I'm a real woman. I have a real body, a real face. You know, I'm a real human that you could date. Let me give you a kiss to show you how real I am. And Roscoe, completely blinded by his obsession with pixels, doesn't give a shit.
Well, then she's okay.
You know what? That is true Sigma mentality. Maybe Roscoe is just a Sigma and I'm looking at it the wrong way. Maybe he knows something we don't know. But Roscoe, man, there's a living, breathing woman in front of you who wants to bang you. And he still decides he would rather have a holographic girl than a real girl. Dude, imagine losing to a hologram. Imagine losing to an anime girl. Just think about that. Think about how you'd feel. So anyway, Roscoe has a deep conversation with his dad over some fancy dinner plates. And his dad basically gives him some advice that every person with an unhealthy relationship with a waifu, husbando, or whatever you want to say.
You will never be Japanese. You will never find the love of your life in Japan who looks like this and is a cutie pie Japanese girl. You'll never be the protagonist in an anime. You will never have superpowers to allow you to overcome your most greatest tribulations. You'll always be a loser.
Anyone who is obsessed with pixels, this is what they need to hear. Because trying to find someone that fits your perfect concept in your mind, yeah, that's impossible. That's what we call an incel. Someone who just hates all women because they aren't the perfect concept of a woman in their mind. But anyway, he just says that you should find someone you love, including all of the imperfections, because that's what makes people perfect. Is the imperfect. And then we get a little heated moment between Roscoe and Loretta, because Roscoe ends up getting all butt hurt that Loretta doesn't love him back because she can't feel.
There. You feel that?
No.
Me neither. Nothing at all.
So anyway, we get Big Corpa coming in and they're like, hey, we're gonna buy Loretta. She's gonna be our property and we're gonna make millions and millions of dollars, and so will you. So yeah, you should probably take the deal. But obviously Roscoe gets all upset. She's mine, she's my girl, she's real to me, dad. Daddy, that's my waifu. Don't let him take my waifu. Then they say, sorry little pup, not my problem. We're gonna take her anyway because we're corporate, you know? Corpas can do what they want. Kind of ironic case of Disney showing that big capitalistic corporations are evil and will steal from you because you can't really do anything about it. I don't know, maybe Disney's projecting. But the producer actually ended up giving Loretta a second choice for herself. He said you could either stay and become a super pop star, or you could just upload yourself to the internet and then do what you want. And she obviously chose the internet. And you know, she ends up running into the creepy dude with the truck again. And children, don't get into random trucks with creepy dudes. Not a good idea. So anyway, we have a problem here. Loretta's gone and they have a concert to do. But Loretta went to the deep web. So Sam gets a cheeky idea of putting on a wig and acting like Loretta. And after a piss poor attempt at a cartwheel, I mean, look at that. That's not even a half cartwheel. Disgusting. But this part of the movie kind of made me laugh, not gonna lie. Because after she attempted that terrible cartwheel, she fell off stage and ended up in a goddamn coma. Now that's a big jump. That's a large jump in this movie. This movie's talking about a holographic girl in a band. All of a sudden, boom, she's in a coma now. So anyway, Loretta ends up making it back. She starts bragging about how she went clubbing. But she finds out that Sam's in a coma, and naturally, she enters her brain. You know, like all holographic AIs do. And what makes matters even worse, or I should say terrifying, whenever Loretta says the line, only one of us can exist here. And then she takes over Sam's body.
It's broken.
Your hardware needs to be rewired.
Loretta? What are you doing here?
I'm here to fix you. It looks like there's only enough room for one of us in here.
Like, her parents are right there watching Loretta steal their child's body and just walk outside, and they're like, oh, okay, it's Loretta. We'll just let her do it. But anyway, Loretta feels the rain, you know, can feel because she's inside of a human. It's a terrifying concept to think that Loretta can now just control people's body. But anyway, Loretta ends up giving back Sam to them and kind of fades into non-existence. And then we get a scene at the end where they're playing in the band, and then we're like, oh, great harmonies. Well, I didn't do that. Loretta! It was Loretta! She's still alive! And then the movie ends. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That was Phil of the Future. Or no, I mean, a pixel perfect. So I hope to all those people out there who have multiple holes in their body pillows sees this movie and thinks, damn, Loretta's hot. Like, damn, I should make a Loretta body pillow. Wait, that's not the message I was going for. What was the message of what was I trying to say again? I don't remember. Oh, have a good day. Don't. Have a bad day.